I went to Israel. I did the Israel thing because, you know, well, you know, it's kind of like a Jewish suction, kind of a vortex. I was actually on a plane going to Barbados, and somehow I got sucked in. But, you know, things happen. So I get off the plane, and I don't know if you've been to Israel, but they're real cocky there. God was born there, so there's really no talking to those people. I mean, off from Jersey, we got Springsteen, different ballgame altogether. You get off the plane in Israel, and it's immediate. They're like, welcome to Israel, the Holy Land. Oh, thanks. I'm from America. Home of the Whopper, so. But here, I'm on like a Jew rampage, you know, and I'm not given equal time. And are there any other Catholics here? Okay, that was pretty repressed. All right, well done. You gotta be real careful, you know, with the Catholics. You say like any Catholics, and usually like one will raise their hand, one will clap, and one will just burst into flames spontaneously and go straight to hell, which is always a very dangerous thing. There's a lot of animosity between Jews and Catholics traditionally, the whole Christ-killing thing, and, you know, I just want to say for the record, I was with my brother the whole day, and, you know, I had nothing to do with it. You know, I heard about it on CNN. Personally, I always thought the guy was a little self-righteous, but I guess that was his gig, you know, which is probably why he was so castable, you know. Well, he's in all those movies, Last Temptation of Christ, Honey, I Shrunk the Christ, you know, he's in a lot of good things now, and he's, I think his career is really, because I, personally, I'm into religion because I think religion provides you with like that out. You know what I mean? Religion allows you to mess up your whole life and still slide home safe to heaven in that final week. You know what I mean? Every religion's got loopholes. Catholics have, what is it? Lent and confession, two beauties. For Jews, it's Yom Kippur, a one-day blowout sale of absolution, ladies and gentlemen. It's the absolution of sin through the abstinence of food. Hello? What a great deal. Mess up all year, don't eat for one day, you're back in the street looking for hookers. What a holiday! Are we, as a religion, letting ourselves off easy? Purifying our souls by skipping lunch? Because if you think about it, Jesus, to absolve sin, had to be nailed to a cross, flogged, wearing the thorny crown of humiliation. I can't believe nobody told him about this other option. I mean... Seems like he'd be out there going, wait. I could have just skipped the Last Supper? Oh my God. I feel like a complete and total savior, for crying out loud. What I think would be the best idea is, why don't we just combine religions? Take like the best of Catholicism, the best of Judaism, combine them in one greatest hits album, Judolicism, you know what I mean? Keep from the Catholics confession, but take from the Jews absolution through cutting calories. Ladies and gentlemen, you could go to confession and your penance would read like a Weight Watchers menu. You could walk in there, forgive me, Father, I have sinned. I have committed sodomy. Well, sodomy, hold on. Whoa, well, I hope you like salads, because... Anyway, thanks a lot. Enjoy the rest of the show. Have a good night.